Let's just five topic Windows Form applications. Lectures plan creating a new form application. Second question, set your form properties. First question, creating a new Windows Form application. Step 1. The first thing you need to start is to creating a new Windows Form project. Select the File, New, Project menu to create the project in a new solution. Step 2. If you have an existing solution, to see to which you want to add a new Windows Form project, select File, Add, New Project. In dictionary, New Words, select Thumb Down. This picture, select Visual C Sharp. Next, select Windows Form application. Next, name, pictures viewers, solution name to the picture viewers, and the location and the project's locations. Step 3. Choose Windows Form application can be created with either C#. Step 4. Application project templates in the default selection when you open the new project dialog box and select the Windows category as shown in Figure 5.1. Step 5. Click OK to create the new Windows Form Applications project. The new words in dictionary create, chrome, and template, shablon. Step 6. The interface contains the three windows, a main windows, solution explorer, and the properties windows. Step 7. If any of these windows are missing, restore the default window layout by on the menu bar, choosing Windows, Reset Windows Layout. You can also display windows by using menu commands. On the menu bar, choose View, Properties Windows, or Solution Explorer. If any other windows are open, close them by closing the Close button in these upper right corners. In dictionary, new words, main windows, bus терезе, главное окно, solution explorer, шишем шолус шоссе, обозреватель решений, and properties windows, коситер терезесе, окно свойств. Main windows. In this window, you will do most of your work, such as working with forms and editing code. In the illustration, the window shows a form in the form editor. At the top of the windows, the Start Page tab and the Form1.cs Decision tab appear. Next, Solution Explorer windows. In this windows, you can view and navigate to all items in your solution. If you choose a file, the contents of the properties windows change. If you open a code file, which ends in .cs in Visual C Sharp, the code file or a designer for the code file appears. A designer is a visual surface onto which you can add controls, such as button and the list. For Visual Studio Forms, the designer is called the Windows Form Designer. Next, Properties Windows. In this window, you can change the properties of the items that you choose in the other windows. For example, if you choose Form 1, you can change its title by setting the text property, and you can change the background color by setting the back color property. Save your program. On the menu bar, choose File, Save All. As an alternative, choose the Save All button on the toolbars. Visual Studio automatically fills in the folder name and the project name and then saves the project in your project folders. In Dictionary, Save All Trier Sachtam. Run your program. Use one of the following methods to run your program. First, choose the F5 case. Second, on the menu bar, choose Debug, Start Debugging. Third, on the toolbar, choose the Start Debugging button, which appears as follows. Start Debugging toolbar button. Figure 5.2. Second question, set your form properties. Step 1. Be sure you are looking at Windows Form this evening. In the Visual Studio Integrated Development Environment, choose the Form1.cs Design tab. Step 2. Choose anywhere inside the Form1 to select it. Look at the properties windows, which should now be showing the properties for the form. Form have various properties. For example, you can set the foreground and the background color, title text that appears at the top of the form, size of the form, and other properties. Step 3. After the form is selected, find the text property in the properties windows. Depending on how the list is sorted, you might need to scroll down. Choose text type, picture view, and the choose enter. Your form should now have the text picture view in its title bar, and the properties window should look similar to the following pictures. And properties windows. Step 4. Look at the properties windows and notice that the size property has changed. The size property changes each time you resize the form. Try dragging the form's handle to resize it to a form size of approximately 350 to be exact, which should for this project. As an alternative, you can enter the values directly in the size property and then choose the enter case. Run your program again. Today we got acquainted with the concept of the form and learned how to change the properties of the form. Thank for your attention. Self-text questions. Reference.